Na, du hast ja das Sermon ja mal Tom, der First Sermon. Message Uri. Be careful of false deliverance. Because there are many deliverances which are false. So be careful of false deliverance. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus Christ was anointed to conduct deliverance. And he has delivered many people during his time of ministry. We have to understand that deliverance comes as a result of a manifestation. Maybe I should have said, be careful of a false deliverance, false manifestation. Because for a deliverance, people will not understand. But the issue here, which I'm addressing, false manifestation, false deliverance. Because if there is a false manifestation, there will be a false deliverance. I'm going to give an example. There are times where I conduct Google session in the house of God, in the absence of the children of God, because sometimes there are many projects which manifest during the week. Most of the time when I conduct a session, the type of a manifestation will be one of the church members. The voice is that of a church member. And when they manifest the ancestor, they even mention the name of a church member. Praise the Lord. Now an ancestor will manifest and say, look, I'm Betty. This is what I'm doing in the house of God. I want to block the work of God. These are the things that I want to do in the house of God. If you don't understand things of the spirit, you are going to attach the manifestation to the to that person. It is not the spirit of that person manifest. It is the spirit behind the person. Do you understand, brother? Praise the Lord. A long time ago, I conducted many deliverances. And there was one manifestation which was really false. On that day, an ancestor manifested many pastors. And these pastors, I could hear that this is Pastor So-and-so's voice. This is Pastor So-and-so's voice. This is Pastor So-and-so's voice. But God told me that no, it's false. It's not the pastors. They are masquerading the voices of the pastor. And it happened in many churches. That a manifestation will happen. And the voice is that of a man of God. And people say, yo, this man of God is a witch. It's not a man of God. It is the ancestor which are connected with the man of God. Sometimes it's the ancestors of the members in his church. What is happening is they are actually masquerading his voice so that people can think that this man of God is a witch. It's not true. It is a false manifestation, more especially when the ancestral spirit manifests and they talk about a man of God and they slander that man of God and they tell you how he bewitches people. It's not God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You have to understand that the devil cannot expose himself. And many people believe in such manifestation. When the spirit manifests a true man of God, and they say, this man of God is under the sea. We are working with this man of God. This is what he's doing. People say, yes, and God has shown me. It's true. I saw this man of God. It's a masquerade. They are masquerading the man of God in their dream. They are also masquerading the man of God's voice. Some of you in your dream you have seen the servants of God and they are transformed into snakes. It's not true. It's the masquerade from the devil to hinder you from your deliverance. A certain lady came to our church a long time ago, and this woman of God said, you know, whenever I go to churches, God shows me about this man of God. I know what they are doing. And I said to her, it's quite interesting that you especially, wherever you go, you can see the sins of the man of God. You can see that this man of God are all cut. It is your ancestor. He knew this man of God are supposed to help you. But when you go there, the enemy will show you false what? False visions and false trance. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not denying that certain things could be true. But you have to be careful. Because you are going to miss your deliverance. You are going to miss your breakthrough. Because this sister is traveling from one church to another. And according to him, all these men of God, they are satanists. Hallelujah. Let's be careful of such manifestation. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's go to Matthew 8, 28 to 34. Matthew 8, 28 to 34. When he arrived at the site of the region of Gadarenes, two demon-possessed men coming from the tombs met him. They were so violent that no one could pass that way. "What do you want with us, Son of God?" they shouted. "Have you come here to torture us before the appointed time?" Some distance from them, a large herd of pigs was feeding. The demons begged Jesus, "If you drive us out, send us into the herds of pigs." He said to them, "Go." So they came out and went into the pigs. And the whole herd rushed down the steep bank into the lake and died in the water. Those tending the pigs ran off, went into the town and reported all this, including what had happened to the demon-possessed man. Then the whole town went out to meet Jesus, and when they saw him, they pleaded with him to leave their region. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So I'm just giving one example of a scripture where Jesus Christ met with two demon-possessed men. And the spirit inside those men, before he can even attack them, they manifested. And they said to him, "What do you want with us, Son of God?" The demons themselves, they spoke with Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. They said to him, "What is it that you want with us? Have you come here to torture us before the appointed time?" They were talking like humans. But the Bible is saying it's demons. But I can tell you today, we know that the ancestors, they are the ones who speak like people. They can reason. Let me tell you, demons, they don't have a reasoning capacity. They cannot reason. They are not instructing Jesus. They told him, "Send us to the pits." And you want to ask me a question? What generation, Mama, they are asking you to send them into the lake of fire? They did that to Jesus. If these are demons, they did that to Jesus. Send us to pigs. If you are sending us out, send us to pigs. Today, our ancestors, they are saying, send us to the lake of fire. Put sulfur on us and send us to the lake of fire. Put us in a bottle. This thing is here in the Bible. Peace.
Amen.
Because I don't want to be seeing who can change a body. But what I'm saying, who? The spirit of the Jesus there. Hello, Warren. Listen, what you be? Can you see ancestor body? Pipas. Listen, Mullo. Listen, Tronco.
Amen.
God is solving a lot of misunderstanding because people sometimes they think that it seems like the ancestors are the ones who are controlling us. They are not controlling us. They are telling us to send them according to their punishment because now Baba, they have to go to the fire. Baba, they have to go to the dungeon. Baba, you have to put sulfur on them. It is allowed. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now, these demons, they manifested because of the presence of God around Jesus.
Amen.
This was a true manifestation from God.
Amen.
They couldn't stand the power. They couldn't stand the fire that was in him. So when they saw him coming, they started to manifest.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That is why sometimes in the house of God, there are certain people they manifest during preaching.
Yeah.
Because of the anointing which is in the house of God.
Mm-hmm.
Some generations they even speak without me asking them. Because of the anointing in the house of God.
Mm-hmm.
They have been involved by what? By the presence of God. By the fire of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So this is how we can detect a true manifestation. The spirit, when they manifest, they will manifest according to the attacks which they have done to someone. But once a spirit starts to manifest and they want to talk about a highly anointed man of God, and you know that this is a man of God, that is very confusing. Whether this manifestation is God. Because many people, they don't know that when the spirit manifests, they manifest according to the mandate of God. There are certain things which they are allowed to speak. They don't just manifest. There is a contract which they have to sign with God to say we are manifesting and these are the confessions. The only thing that they have to confess is the truth. But with demons, it's different. Because God will never make an agreement with demons.
Mm.
When demons manifest, they lie.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
These are the spirits, when they manifest, they will tell you, you are a man of God. You are highly anointed. I see fire. I'm afraid of you. You are a great man of God. Universally, you are very great. Our pastors, they don't hate you. We are afraid of you.
Hey.
Deceiving spirits.
Yep.
The spirits, they want you to feel big. When they are manifesting at the same time, they are attacking you. They are putting pride in you. They are putting thoughts in your mind so that you can think that I'm great. I am more than all the pastors. I'm a universal pastor. No pastors like me. I'm the only one gifted. Because when they're manifesting, they are also releasing spirits in you. When a spirit manifests, they must only manifest according to their mandate. So if you're a deliverance minister, when the spirit starts to manifest and they want to tell you that you are big, you are high, you must stop them immediately. And say, no, why are you here? And they'll confess what they came for. Praise the Lord. So let us be careful with false manifestation, false deliverances that are happening. Sometimes you watch a television, you see a spirit is manifesting a man of God. All of us, we know that that man is a man of God. and you start believing that spirit. 1 John chapter 4, verse 1 says, test the spirit and see if they are coming from God.
Amen.
Test the spirit. We must do it. We must test the spirit and see if they are coming from God.
Yeah.
We have a mandate to test. You don't need a manifestation to know if this spirit is from the devil or from God. You must test.
Mm.
You have the Holy Spirit, which will help you to discern if the spirit is from God.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So now, the question is, but manifestations are everywhere. Deliverances are everywhere. What kind of a power is this? Let me tell you. There's another power that portrays itself as the power of God.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
And that is the first power. That is Antichrist spirit. I spoke about Antichrist, I think 2 weeks back. Antichrist spirit portrays itself as the spirit of God. People who are possessed by Antichrist, they pray for people, people got healed, but it's temporary. So what is happening is that when they pray for you, actually, you don't even get your healing. You know, it's like your sickness is suspended. But at the same time, when they pray for you, there's a deposit of a stronger sickness than the one that you have. And the type of sickness that you came with is being suspended. It's like you are healed and you are not healed. But another level of sickness is being deposited in your body. Antichrist preaches the gospel. Antichrist is a deliverance minister. He uses false power. He uses false fire. Antichrist works with gods, not God. God is a smaller God. Anyone who's possessed by the spirit of Antichrist, it means there's a little God in their body. That man of God, a woman of God, is not a man, it's not him who's actually ministering. It's a God in his body. He's been possessed by that God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to Leviticus chapter 10, verse 1. Leviticus chapter 10, verse 1. And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer and put fire therein, and put incense thereon, and offer strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not to. This is the story of Nadab and Abihu. They took the censers, and when they were supposed to wait upon the Lord, they put strange fire on the incense. And the kind of strange fire which they put, it is the fire that God told them not to put there.
Mm.
This is an authorized fire. That's what we are saying. It is an authorized fire.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God commanded them not to put an authorized fire. We call it strange fire. Immediately after they put that fire, God, they died. God killed them. Because that fire was not authorized. Most of you, when you came for deliverance, your ancestors told you that we are coming from a generation of unauthorized fire. We are coming from a generation of strange fire. In your body, all the time, you feel fire. You are burning. He uses an authorized choir. Antichrist can also perform miracles. But I don't want to go deep into that area. I just want to talk this first deliverance. So Antichrist uses strange fire. So a lot of people who are not delivered from the ancestral spirit, what happens is when you pray for people, they start to fall, and you think it's the fire of God. It is not the fire of God, it's that fire of the ancestor. Even Lord, praise the Lord. I'll not forget a certain lady told me, she came to my church, and when she saw me delivering people, this lady, she was a provider. She told me that even me as a provider, I have fire. There are witch doctors who use fire to help their own people. Give me Lord, I'm both a lena. Can I look on Lord? I'm not Lord, I'm not Lord, I'm not Lord. Because now that lady has been initiated to a level of agreement. So what happens to this particular person? Here, what I'm going to just do. If I bring deliverance, oh God, then I have a fire of the world. Can't give me the Lord of the ancestor. I get a deliverance from that strange fire. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So now, I'm going to go to the Lord. Now this lady, because she's possessed by the gods of strange fire in her body, and because now she's saved, so Muruti Haisali and Muruti in the god inside her body. So because there's a god who stays in her body, when she starts to open a ministry, the ancestors will have an agreement with the ancestor that our son is or daughter is opening a ministry. Send your children. Now the man of God or the woman of God will start to send invitation. As he's sending invitation, that invitation will pick those who are alive, who are connected with generation, who have agreed. That their children they must join that church. So here in the natural, most of the people when they get the invitation, they renounce the invitation and have a desire to go to that church. When they go there, they say, oh, this is my church, and they stay there. So what is happening is, this generation who have made an agreement with the generation of this man of God or woman of God who's possessed by these gods of fire, his level is higher than the generation who will be joining the church. Because in their agreement, they are going to agree that our son is a prophet, but is also a deliverance minister. Means when our son is in fire, you must fall. So you know what is happening is, these people, I mean, the natural people, when they come to church, it's not them who are coming to church, it's the generation who's in there, who's in there, inside their body. Yes, Allah,
yes.
Now the generation who signed the agreement with the generation of that man of God, woman of God, they are the ones who are coming to church inside the body of their children. Remember already there's a church under earth.
Yeah.
And remember already an exercise was done under earth. Because before they can fall, in the land of the living, already they have manifested down there. So now when they come, you preach and preach and preach, and when they start to say fire, people fall. In the generation inside that body, the man of God, the God inside that man of God is the one who's conducting the fire, the generation they run.
Hey.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I want you to be careful. If you can watch certain services, people are never delivered. They are forever down, falling.
There's a manifestation from the ancestor. A long time ago, I went to a funeral. Now, there was a choir which was singing at the funeral. So a certain lady manifested. And I went there because I wanted to see what is happening. Some other people came around here. There are also some Sangomas. They said, no, don't touch her. And they were talking with that ancestor, with the, you know, kneeling down. And the ancestor even told them in Zoma that they must tell me to go. The ancestor wanted to talk with the daughter something. That is ancestral manifestation. They can just appear, manifest, using their own evil path if they want to talk with their children. So a lot of people in the world, they know about manifestation. That is why we Christians, when you say fire, people are manifesting, they're looking at you. Because one night they never come in. Yes, God, that was that. Praise the Lord. Everything that we do, the world knows. It's just that one by a feet. So when we invite someone to come to church for a Google session, we are very excited that today you are going to enjoy. You will hear how God works. You don't know, but there are certain people, they go and consult our family where they have been Googled. Don't only Google our family. It doesn't go deep, but that's right. Many people, they know about Google, not our family. Where they speak with their ancestor there, good level entry. Am I right?
Yep.
You come now, brother, you come up to the right house and say, family. What are the Google ever family?
Jesus.
You still remember asking the relay project ever family? What are the Google ever family? So don't have to develop who are the Google no. Can the Google you have to do why? Everybody can do that. I can't have family. Copy a microphone. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
things are not the same. There's Christ, there's Antichrist. There are miracles that belong to Christ, there are miracles that belong to the devil. But they are temporal.
Yep.
Amen.
It is true, yeah, exist, and then generation city very certain types on a Mundau, which is the queen of the seven seas. There are two types, there's the other one in the sea, then there's the other one in the river, that is Mundau, which will work together in Munguni. Munguni is also the tribes of the those people who died during the times of Mfecane. Those are the two generations. Now, during the process, the whole process of family, this is what's going to happen. You'll be diagnosed by bones. Within that bones, the ancestors that brought you there, they talk to Isangoma to tell you what they expect.